Hello guys, this is Noon, we're having a nap. Wolf, say hi to everybody. Wolf. Ears dropped, we're sleepy. Wolf! Don't bother me. Of course, when you start filming videos at high noon, I feel sleepy. I just had some lunch and I want to rest. I will leave him. Now guys, let's see where we are. You can see here, I have used some wood putty. I will use a lot more of that because the surfaces are going to be painted, but that's for another time. Here at this point I'm going to change the way I'm going to do the planking. Also I'm going to show you something. Let me get this stain away. You see here we have some small steps. This is normal. This big one isn't. So this big step is telling me that it's time to change the way I do the planking. This big step will be fixed. I'm going to show you how. But now, first, I'm going to place the camera on a tripod because we're going to do the planking in a different way. So let me do that and I'll get back to you to continue. So guys, let's see now how to do the planking here. We stopped at this point, so we're going to begin at this point, of course, from the keel, and we'll meet up all the way down there, but with a different way. Now, the first plank will go like this. Definitely, I will have to do some bending here, but let me find out where is where. This needs some trimming. I'm not going to delay using sandpaper at the moment. So, here it's where it ends. Let's mark everything. What I have to do now is bend this piece a bit. Let me do that and I'll get back to you. Now guys, as you can see, I have bent a lot, but also I need to do some more bending with a different way. Let me show you something. This is straight, horizontal. Straight, horizontal. And here the piece must go with a small angle, like that. So here I have to twist this piece at this point to make it fit. You can see, must go like this. Easy to do. Just wet this. Just a moment. Okay. And now what I have to do is twist it. You can see it's twisted. So now I have the fit. And the piece is ready to be glued. Let's do that. Definitely I'm going to need a pin or two to make this stay there until I will place a second. Now because of the pressure, and this is 3 millimeters, I could feel it moving, so I had to use some strength underneath, opposite strength, to make sure that it won't break. That's why this should not be 3 millimeters. This should be 5, at least 4, but 5 is the best. An inexperienced modeler could easily break it, and then it will be hell. This one is done. Let's proceed to the second one. We'll start from here and we'll end up here, like this. You can understand that I do not need all that long. Again, let's mark everything. I'm not going to bend this with the soldering iron. I'm just going to make it wet, and I'm going to twist it again. Probably you will break a couple of them until you get the hang of it, but don't worry about that. There's always spare wood in the box. Perfect. Let's glue this. Epping here is the best way to preserve the piece glued, because now we're going to apply some force. It's perfect. Not over yet. We have to apply some white glue underneath. Alright guys, let's put a second one. Now, the second one will begin from here. Don't mind about being correct with the blanking from the top, because like I said, this is going to be painted, so you're going to use wood putty and nothing will be visible. Don't bother to make it be correct, like we have here, or here, or here. Do it with the way you love, and you can. Again, mark everything. I'm not going to need all that. Now, let me bend it and I'll get back to you. Here is a strip. You can see that it's slightly bended and twisted. A lot of bending over here. It has a small curve over here. It's twisted, and a lot of bigger curve over here. So it's a perfect fit. Like it was there, and just took it off. It's a perfect fit. Now, let's place it. If you're wondering why I put glue on the strip and not where it will be touching in the skeleton, it's because the skeleton is absorbing the glue, and first I don't have the time to fill up a new glue before it gets absorbed, and secondly it's a waste of glue. With this way I can do exactly what I want with the amount of glue that is needed actually. Easy. To the other end. Again, mark everything. So from this point we need to twist. Again, same procedure, just some water, and we have to do it like this. It's perfect. Perfect. To glue it. Let me put some white glue. I will remove these pins, no need them, do not need them anymore. And I'm going to show you how to fix the big step at the bow. So guys, here we have the big step. This works even with a non-painted hull. This is going to be painted, like I said, so nothing will be visible. But you can do the same thing to a hull that is not painted. First of all, let's see what we need. We need a piece of wood. We have the the step that the big part is from here and up to here. So we need to cover this area somehow. What we're going to do is place another piece above this one, bended and exactly in the same width, glue it, and when we're going to sand down everything, it's going to be flat. It's not that easy, like I'm describing it, but it will do the trick. First of all, let me choose a little bigger to be able to work with. We have to trim this piece. Yeah, beautiful. Now I have to bend this piece. So from here and up to here, I have to make it curved. Let's see if it fits. It's a perfect fit. You can tell. Here we are. It's perfect. So, first of all, we're covering this piece. Let's take it up to the bow and all the way over here. No, because the curve is better here. So we're covering this piece all the way to here. Let me cut this. Perfect. To glue it. This is the part that must be most careful. You have to make sure that it's glued perfectly, have no gaps, because if it has gaps, you're going to find them out when you sand it. So when this surface is going to be sanded, everything will be flat and we have no steps. That's how you make the correction on these big steps, and that's how it's going to be different part of the hull. I'm going to meet you again when I will close the hull on one side, and we'll do another video. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Me and Wolf, we will see you again soon.